What's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to break down another Tinder conversation example. Specifically, I'm going to show you how you can go from the opener to having the girl come straight to your place the same day. All right, before we jump into the video, I do have one ask. If you guys are enjoying the content on this channel, you want to see more awesome videos like this, do me a favor and smash the subscribe button. It really helps us grow the channel, allows us to keep making more free content. With that aside, let's jump right into the screenshots. So I open the girl with a standard, hey, trouble, and yes, it still works. She replies with a fairly low investment, hello. I say, you seem like potentially my type, which is a follow-up message I quite often use, and she says, hello. So I recognize the fact that this is poor English, you know, she just doesn't really have a big English vocabulary, so I just kind of let this slide and I say, are you from here originally? No, I'm Venezuelan, Latina. I say, ah, mi favorita, which means my favorite. She says, aha, hablas español, you like Venezuelans. I say, I speak gringo Spanish. Yes, my ex-girlfriend was from Valencia, which is a city in Venezuela, so this is something I commonly do wherever, you know, place the girl's from. You know, I either know someone there or I've dated someone there. In this case, it's actually true, but, you know, this is like a good way to establish comfort and value. She says, arepa, haha, I don't know why she makes that joke, how good. I say, do you like wine? So here I'm about to go for the close. Says, hello, Alex. I think you're in Europe, haha, because of the time difference. I like wine and you. Your profession is a sexologist. If that dog that you have in your photos is yours, could you give it to me as a gift? I love that breed of dog. So you can see that just by being persistent and just kind of keeping the conversation going in the early phase stages, it can pan out and the girl might invest later on. So this happens all the time, especially with foreign girls. I say, haha, nope, I don't check this app much. He is, but I would never give him away. And yes, it is. I don't check either. If I had one, if I had one, I wouldn't give it to you either. And here, I just want to move it to WhatsApp because she tells me she's not good at this app. And, you know, I want to actually get her over that night because, you know, nature has an urge. So I say, do you have WhatsApp? She says, yes, gives me her number. So I send her my name. She sends me her name. I say, ah, yes, my favorite Venezuelan. So throwing a little humor into the mix. She says, haha, Venezuelan, please send me a photo of your dog. Because she said, please. If she had just said, send me a photo of your dog, I would have said, say please. But because she did that and she asked nicely, I sent her a few funny pictures of Rhaegar looking extra adorable. Says, aha. And then here I move it over towards the meetup. I say, he says he's excited to meet you. So that's a very smooth, progressive way of going towards the meetup, right? You do it at first in an indirect way, then you go for the soft close. She says, aha, me too. She says, ¿cuál es su nombre? So here I misunderstand her. I thought she was asking for my name, which I already told her. So I say this, my name is Alex. She says, no, I'm talking about your dog. What's the name of your dog? It's Rhaegar. And then she sends me a Instagram link of just like people, you know, just cute husky shit on Instagram. So I say, love it. What are you doing tonight? Do you understand Spanish? Good or so-so? I don't know. Some friends told me to go out, but I don't know. So this sounds like she does not have concrete plans, so I can potentially get her over. I say, so-so, I have a better idea, dot, dot. She says, qual, what? I say, you, me, and Rhaegar split a bottle of wine on my romantic balcony. So that's my cutesy way of inviting the girl over. She says, where do you live? I say, Brickle. She doesn't respond. So half an hour later, I double text. Usually I don't recommend waiting 24 hours, but this is a time sensitive situation. So I say, you. She tells me her area. I say, oh, you're only 20 minutes away. She says, so we're going to talk and we're just going to talk and drink wine. So here, the thing is to say is, yes, I don't want to say like, and we're going to fuck, right? Because that's going to trigger her anti-slut defense. So at this point, it's kind of low-key agreed that, you know, we are going to hook up. There's no need for me to be explicit about it. And quite often with foreign girls, especially Latina girls, you don't want to be super explicit that they're coming over for sex because that triggers their anti-slut defense. So I say, see, Amor says, and you will, so here she says, you will pick me up, Google Translate. I say, haha, of course, I'll order you an Uber here and drive you home. She says, how's 10:30? I say, perfect. And here's just logistics. Then she's here, I say, coming, conveniently spelled C-U-M. She's like, I'm in front of the restaurant. And after she leaves, I say, buenas noches, chica bonita, which is pretty girl. And she says, thank you, I'm home. Have a good night. And I say, good night. So you can see it works out quite well. So this one is quite simple and straightforward, but the point I'm always trying to preach is that these things don't have to be super complicated. Sometimes it really is just that easy. You know, you just are persistent. You take care of, you know, potential concerns that come up, like the girl asking, you know, oh, you know, you're going to drive me home. Yeah, of course I'm going to drive you home. Oh, so we're just going to drink wine and talk. Yeah, sure, we're just going to drink wine and talk, right? So it's just understanding basic female psychology in game and just moving things forward can be enough to get you laid, even the same night. Now, usually if the girl says she's not free that night, I'm not going to push for it. At that point, I was scheduled for another night. All right, hopefully you guys found this breakdown valuable. Let me know in the comments if you want to see more of these details from start to finish lay report breakdowns. As I mentioned earlier, do us a favor and smash that like button, hit subscribe, and click the bell for notification. Otherwise, Rhaegar will hunt you down and will lick the shit out of you. Thank you guys for watching. Until next time.